What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about how to send an email when your SCCM task sequence completes a deployment. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is open up our configuration manager. Boom. Once that's up and running, we're going to click on the monitor tab. Within the monitor tab, we are going to get into the system status folder and click on status message. Boom. Now, locate all status messages, right-click on it, and then select show messages. Click OK. It's going to load up. And the reason why we're here is because we need to locate that special message ID that tells you when the task sequence has completed. So sort all the message IDs, and we are going to locate the one that's 11,171, all right? That is the one. If you look at the description, it says the task sequence manager successfully completed execution of the task sequence. That is the one that we want. So jot down that message ID because we will be using it pretty soon. So close that up. We need to head over to the software section. Within the software section, let's open up the operating system folder, click on the task sequence, and select your task sequence. Now, the task sequence that I want to get notified would be the following. And the reason why I'm telling you this is because we need to get the package ID. Now, the package ID would be 48. That is the one that I want to get notified, all right? So the package ID for the task sequence and also the message ID, those two things are very important because we are going to be using it pretty soon. So from here, we're going to head to administration. Within administration, open up the site configuration folder. Click on sites, select your site, right click on it, and select status filter rules. It's going to load this up. We're going to click on create. Now, first thing that we need to do is provide a name. So give it a name. This is what I provided. Pretty self-explanatory. We've got a bunch of options to enable, and I enable the following. So the first one that we are going to enable would be source. Click on the drop-down menu. It is going to be a client. Awesome. Now, the next one that we are going to enable would be message ID, and type in or paste what you copied before, which would be 11,171, which is the message ID that we want. And the next setting that we are going to enable would be property, and click on the dropdown, and we are going to do package ID, and then enable property value. Click on the dropdown, and then select your task sequence, which for me was 48. Awesome. Click on next. Now we need to specify the action. We are going to enable run a program. Now the program that we are going to be using would be PowerShell, and we are going to be using a PowerShell script. I dropped my PowerShell script within this particular folder, which is located within the SCCM server in the D drive. I created a folder called scripts, and I dropped the PowerShell script in here. So I'm going to open it up. I'm going to show you guys. I'm not going to go over everything. I will provide this PowerShell script inside my GitHub so you guys can get a copy of it and just make all the changes that you need. I define my SMTP server. I define the port, the username, and the password. I am going to convert the password into a secure string. I am also declaring the credentials and also defining the email, which would be who is it from? Who is it going to, the subject line and the body, and then last but not least, line 20 is using the command of send mail message with all the variables that I declared above it to send out the email. I'm going to open up Notepad, and I'm going to show you the command that we need to copy and paste into the run as. So this is what we need to run. I'm going to be calling out the PowerShell exe file, and then defining where the PowerShell script is located and giving it the parameter of computer name, and also the parameter of TS, which we define within our PowerShell script. So I'm going to copy that. I'm going to paste it in here. Boom, click next. A nice little summary. Click next again. Green check mark. Awesome. Let's close it. And there goes our status filter rule. So we are going to click OK. Next thing that we need to do is test out your deployment. So everything worked out with no problem. I tested the deployment that I wanted to get an email from, and I check my inbox, and there goes the notification. How awesome is that? Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.